Today, I'm going to talk to you about the effects of two anti-tumoral drugs used in chemotherapy, such as doxorubicin and trastuzumab, on the left and the right ventricle function. The cardiotoxicity has a significant impact on cancer patient management, and it is characterized by a significant decrease in left ventricle ejection fraction, leading to heart failure. The most important antitumoral drugs that induce this disease are the doxorubicin and trastuzumab. Doxorubicin is an anthracycline used in many tumors, including breast cancer. It is one of the effective antitumoral drugs developed until now, but its clinical application is limited by persistent cardiac side effects. In addition, the doxorubicin increases this cardiac dysfunction when is administered together or before antibodies target. Such as trastuzumab. Trastuzumab is an humanized monoclonal Fab2 antibody, a proton coat gene associated with poor diagnosis in breast cancer. It improves the survival of these patients, but clinical trials have reported that it causes cardiotoxicity in combination with trastuzumab. The incidence of this effect ranges from 4 to 7% when it administered in monotherapy, but it reached up 16 to 17% when it administered with doxorubicin. Cardiotoxicity induced by doxorubicin is most complex, and it is not well understood yet. The generation of reactive oxygen species play a role fundamental in this disease. The ROS induce change in iron metabolism, induce alteration in sarcomeric structure, induce the protein lipid oxidation, and most recently doxorubicin can be induced DNA damage by interacting with topoisomerase beta 2. Trastuzumab, binding to Fab2, blocks the Fab2-Fab4 dimerization. And this blocking the cardioprotection mechanism essential during oxidative stress. When trastuzumab is administered together or after doxorubicin, the oxidative stress increases because trastuzumab blocks these cardioprotective effects, and we have cardiac dysfunction. Why the heart? The doxorubicin has an higher affinity to cardiolipin localized to the inner mitochondrial membrane, and these induce selective accumulation of this drug in mitochondria, and the DART is rich in mitochondria. The other side, trastuzumab blocks the extracellular domain of RB2, localized in two myocardial transverse tubules, and these salines downstream signaling factors that modulate the gene expression implicated in cardioprotection signaling. The aims of our study were to develop and characterize a new mouse model of cardiotoxicity that reproduce the clinical therapeutic protocols of multiple cycles of doxorubicin followed by trastuzumab treatment, and also to evaluate the cardiac injury in both left and right ventricles. For our experimental protocol, we have used the female wild type divided in five groups. In group one, doxorubicin is administered in six equal intraperitoneal injection over a period of 2 weeks in the second group. Here, the trastuzumab is administered also in six equal injection intraperitoneal. In group three, mice were treated with saline in the same manner as doxo and trastuzumab groups. In group four, sorry, in group four, after 1 week of recovery following doxo treatment, mice were treated with six injections of trastuzumab again for 2 weeks. The mice were treated with saline injection, simulating the four group doxo and trastuzumab group. Sorry. Allora, we performed the measurement to baseline at the end. Yes, thank you very much. At the end of treatment, day 14, 1 week after the end of treatment, day 41, and 4 weeks after the end of treatment. The cardiac function was measured by echocardiography technique. This technique allows is a non-invasive method to evaluate the cardiac function, and it permits to follow the same animal over time. A combination of ultrasound and Doppler imaging can be used to obtain a bidimensional measurement of heart and intracardiac blood flow. In the mice, the small size and the rapid heart rate represent a challenge for acquiring higher quality images, and also the anesthesia is very important for the acquisition because higher levels the anesthesia decrease significantly cardiac performance. Here you can see the most important setups used for measurement the cardiac performance in rodent animals. In the top, you can see the Vevo 200-1000, and in bottom, the most recent Vevo 3100. The animal is anesthetized in induction chamber, and after it placed in on the table here, and it remains anesthetized by using nose mask mask with isoflurane. For acquisition during acquisition, the isoflurane is sets between 1 and 1.5% in this manner we have an heart rate over 415, and this is very important because when we use higher levels of isoflurane, we have a decrease in heart rate, and we have a dilated ventricles. Here, you can see one example of the left ventricle in long axis view. Okay, for to start the video. Okay, here. No. The before. Okay. Here. Yes. In here, you can see the aorta, the left ventricle cavity, the apex, left ventricle anterior wall thickness, and the left ventricle posterior wall thickness. In the right panel, you can see the left ventricle in short axis. In this view, you can see the muscle papillary. Here you can see an example of the left ventricle in long axis after doxo treatment. In this case, you can see dilated left ventricle compared to control condition. Here you can see the representative the representative M mode echocardiography for left ventricle for our studies. We observed compared to control. With doxo and trastuzumab treatment an increase in left ventricle ejection systole volume and a left ventricle and diastolic volume, a significant reduction in left ventricle ejection fraction, and a significant reduction in left ventricle anterior wall thickness at systole. At day 42, we observed an additional increase in left ventricle and systolic volume in doxo transducema group, but not for left ventricle and diastolic volume. We observed an reduction, significantly reduction in left ventricle ejection fraction in doxo transducema group, and also significant reduction in left ventricle anterior wall thickness at systole in doxo transducema group. In contrast, transducema treatment at day 14-2 had reverted two baseline values all parameters. So transducema treatment has induced reversible reversible cardiotoxicity, left ventricle dysfunction. Here, these results were confirmed also by left ventricle hemodynamic measurement. These results were obtained introducing catheter in the left ventricle. And you can see here a shift to right of the loop of doxo for doxo and doxo transducema groups compared to saline and transducema and compared to control and transducema group. This shift in green was more pronunciated compared to doxo treatment alone. The second aim of our study was to evaluate the right ventricle injury during doxo transducema treatment. In comparison with the left ventricle, right ventricle is thin. It has an anatomy, a complex anatomy, and the evaluation of right ventricle function is more difficult. Here you can see how to visualize the right ventricle in mice model. In general, in mice, the right ventricle is not clearly visible because of the interference of sternum. In alternative, it's not visible in short axis view, but it's possible to visualize the right ventricle in B mode and after to perform the M mode to measure the right ventricle internal diameter at diastolic and systolic conditions. In this manner, this phase of two acquisition the right ventricle is more reproducible and easy to do. Here you can see a representative B mode and B mode echocardiography images for right ventricle. The right ventricle as a triangular shape and to measure the right ventricle ejection fraction is most complicated and is not easy. For this reason, we have decided to calculate in M mode the right ventricle internal diameter at diastole and systole for our experiments. And we observed that compared to control and trastuzumab treatment, doxo treatment induced a significantly increase in right ventricle internal diameter at systole, both day 21 and day 42. But not for, conversely, right ventricle internal diameter at diastole did not change at day 41, but it changed at the end of experiment, the study. In addition, we observed an increase, an additional increase of in right ventricle internal diameter at systole in doxo trastuzumab treatment compared doxo treatment alone. This increase is more pronunciated. Another parameter to measure the right ventricle function is the pulmonary artery pulse wave Doppler. Here you can see the peak velocity of the pulmonary artery. And again, doxo treatment induces a significant decrease in pulmonary artery velocity at day 21, and this decrease was remain similar at day 42, but we observed significantly decrease in pulmonary artery velocity in doxo trastuzumab group. These results were confirmed also by right ventricle hemodynamic measurement. And here you can see the PV loop for our groups. And again, you can see a shift to right for PV loops of doxo and doxo trastuzumab treatments compared to saline and doxo and trastuzumab alone. And again, this shift is more pronunciated in doxo trastuzumab treatment. So these results demonstrated that dilated of right ventricle. The histological analysis also confirmed the echocardiography and hemodynamic results. These analysis were performed at the end of experiment. And again, we observed a decrease for doxo treatment. We observed a decrease in both in left and right free wall thickness, and this decrease is more pronounced for doxorubicin treatment. So, in conclusion, trastuzumab causes a reversible right ventricle dysfunction. The doxorubicin treatment induces a permanent left and right systolic dysfunction, and these phenotype was increased after subsequent trastuzumab treatment. This model may open to human studies to evaluate the contribution of right performance in cancer therapy, because just until now, for cardiotoxicity, it examined only left ventricle function. In this case, we demonstrated that also right ventricle can be effect of cancer treatment. Thank you for your attention. And I'm sorry for